Hello everyone. Today we will discuss the characteristics of the critical flow profiles on that are formed on the critical slope basically. So we have earlier seen that two type of GVF profiles are possible that can be formed on a critical slope. So those were C1 and C3. So today we'll try to look at some details of those profiles. All right, so basically a critical profile, C1 profile or any C3 profile, it will be formed on a critical slope. So first we will try to draw a critical slope. By critical slope we mean that we have, suppose, a slope like this. So basically, suppose we have slope, bed slope. The bed slope is such that it is exactly equal to the critical slope. What it means is you already have the critical depth line. You can directly draw the critical depth line here. Okay, so this is your critical depth line basically. It is nothing but the line which denotes your YC. Okay. And it can be found very easily just by applying the condition of critical flow, that is Q square by G equal to A cube by P. Okay. This is your critical flow condition. Okay. If you just apply this condition, here everything is known, the discharge is known, the channel dimensions are known, only unknown is the critical depth. So you can just calculate the critical depth and draw the critical depth line like this. Now, one thing to remember here is that it has, the critical depth has nothing to do with the bed slope. It depends upon basically the discharge and the channel geometry. Okay, so this critical depth line will not change even if you change the slope. Okay, that is the one thing which you should always remember. Now, where does this critical slope comes in picture? Now, suppose this value of the slope is such that you get normal depth equal to critical depth itself. So suppose you calculate normal depth. Okay, so normal depth you will calculate by this formula. Suppose Q equal to A by N R to the power 2 by 3 SB to the power half. Okay, so you have slope, you have the discharge, you have the channel geometry, Manning's roughness coefficient, etc. So if you have all this data, you can easily calculate the normal depth YN. Okay, only unknown is YN. So if you calculate that and you find that, okay, this YN is also equal to YC. So your normal flow will take place at a critical depth. That means uniform flow is going to take place at a critical depth. Then this channel becomes a critical slope, or the slope becomes a critical slope. It's a unique condition. So this is NDL and CDL line will be same. Now here, as NDL and CDL lines are same, you have two flow zones basically. This is zone number 3, the zone above the channel bed, zone below the first line. Now here both lines are same, so CDL and NDL. So this is zone number 3. Above this line, we don't have a flow zone between these two lines. Okay, so both lines are same. So your zone number 2 is absent on a critical slope, but the zone number 1, it will be above both these lines. Okay. So suppose your flow, gradually varied flow, is taking place somewhere here. Okay, so your flow depth will be greater than the normal depth also and critical depth also. So for basically for C1 profile, what happens? Y is greater than YN. And Y is greater than YC also. Okay, so what happens because of this? The governing equation of GVF is dy by dx equal to SB 1 minus YN upon Y whole cube upon 1 minus YC by Y whole cube. Okay, this is not the actual or the equation, direct equation of GVF, but it is a derived equation for a wide rectangular channel. Okay. Since it becomes easy to analyze the profiles by this equation, we are using it. All right. Now, if you look at the dy by dx when the flow is in this C1 profile, then let's look at the value of dy by dx. You see, the value of SB is a positive number. Okay, because the slopes, falling slopes, we consider positive. What happens to the numerator? It is 1 minus yn by y cube. Now, yn by y, if you look at this, then yn is less than y. Okay, y is greater than yn. Fine. What happens? Because of this, this number basically is less than 1. Okay, less than 1. Okay, and cube of this number is again less than 1. So 1 minus something less than 1 becomes a positive number. So in the numerator, we have a positive number. In the denominator, if you see, it is the same thing. 1 minus yc by y cube. Yc is also less than y. So this number will be less than 1. Again, cube of a number which is less than 1 is again less than 1. So this entirely becomes 1 minus something less than 1. It becomes a positive number. Okay, so entirely the dy by dx is a positive value for C1 slope. Okay. So dy by dx is positive. Therefore, the C1 profile will be a rising profile. Okay. One more interesting thing is that now both these numerators and denominators will be same because yn and yc are equal. Okay. So these terms will get cancelled and dy by dx will be exactly equal to SB. Okay. And what it means is, it means that it does not mean that this is parallel, both these lines will be parallel as in the uniform flow. Dy by dx will be like this. It will be a straight line, horizontal line. Okay. Horizontal line. Why? Because I'll just draw it horizontal. So this will be a horizontal line like this. Okay. Now why it is horizontal? See, dy by dx will be equal to SB itself. Okay. So SB means the dy by dx is measured with respect to the channel base, this channel bottom. So this is y. So the line of reference is this parallel to this channel bottom. So this angle and this angle will be same. So it will be theta. That's why now here it is dy by here it is SB, so here also it will be SB. So this line will be horizontal. C1 profile will be horizontal, and this angles will be same, theta and theta here, theta here. Okay, because dy by dx is measured with respect to this line. Okay, this line, this channel bottom, and this line is parallel. Okay, so angle will be between these two lines. All right. Now, even if this is horizontal, it does not mean that dy by dx is not changing. It is a rising profile because if you take y here, it will measure from this channel bottom. So this y is different. Okay, it is greater. So we will have a dy by dx positive. Okay, so this is how the C1 profile will behave. Now at the upstream, y tends to yc and yn. Okay, at upstream it will become yc and yn. Now what happens to the dy by dx? If you look at the equation again, this basically yn, y becomes equal to yn, y becomes equal to yc. So this term becomes 1 and this term also becomes 1. So numerator will be 0 and denominator will be also 0. So it will be basically 0 by 0. So that is undefined. Okay, so this case is undefined. And at the downstream, basically y is governed by the y of control section. Okay. Suppose you can have some, I'll just erase this. So you can have some barrier like this. Okay. So this flow will be governed by this control section. Okay. And upstream it is undefined. Okay, there can be some phenomena like the formation of hydraulic jump or something like that will happen at the upstream, depends upon the case. So this is how a C1 profile will behave. It's a rising curve. It is horizontal in the plane if we see, because the slope angles will be same. Okay, so it is something like this. So we have a rising profile. Okay, so it is almost horizontal. So if you put a sluice gate, this is another example. On a critical slope, if you put a sluice gate, then behind the sluice gate you will find a C1 GVF curve. Okay. In the same way, if we look at the C3 profile, so for C3 profile, I'll again draw the slope. Okay, and we know that your slope. So again, your SB is equal to SC, that is critical slope. And both lines are same, critical depth line and normal depth line are one and the same, YM equal to YC. Okay. Now here, when the flow GVF is taking place in the third flow zone, that is in here. Okay, so Y. Then this profile will be a C3 profile. Okay. Now, if whether it is a rising or falling profile, we just have to look at the dy by dx. Okay. It is SB 1 minus yn by y whole cube 1 minus yc by y whole cube. So SB is again positive. Now, this y is less than yn. So this number is greater than 1. So cube of this number is greater than 1. 1 minus something greater than 1 is a negative number. So numerator is negative. Similarly, denominator is also negative because yc is also less than y. Okay. So again, overall this divided by dx becomes positive. Okay. And same value, divided by dx value is also equal to hb. So again, we get a rising profile. C3 is a rising profile, and again it is horizontal because slope is if you calculate the slope theta, it will be same. Okay. So this is basically our C3. Now at the upstream, y tends to 0. If you go back like this, y tends to 0, and when y becomes 0, your dy by dx becomes 0. Basically, it becomes 0 upon 0. So it is again undefined. Okay. So in reality, it will be governed by some boundary conditions. For example, some sluice gate like this. Okay. So flow will take place below this sluice gate. Okay. Now at the upstream, at the downstream, the y tends to yn and yc. So this is also, we have seen that dy by dx becomes 0 of, y becomes equal to yn means this is 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0 by 0 is again undefined. Okay. So this is not defined here. Okay. So it depends upon the practical condition which will govern this flow in this zone. Okay. this is kind of an example. So we have on a critical slope, if you put a sluice gate, downstream of the sluice gate, you are going to get a C3 profile. Okay. So these are the characteristics of C1 and C3 profiles. Both are rising profiles. All right. Thank you.